Hello everyone, I'm Shaima Ramadan, lecturer of anatomy and embryology faculty of medicine for girls Cairo Azhar University and the Femur Fellow 2021. My project entitled Applying e-learning tools for interactive teaching in integrated medical program at Faculty of Medicine for Girls Cairo Azhar University. My project advisor, Dr. Abubaida Yassin. Many medical schools around the world have integrated online learning approach, and most recently, medical schools have been markedly challenged by COVID-19 with mandates to reduce physical contact and make all or most learning and assessment available online via distance teaching modalities. This has resulted in massive adaptation in medical education, with major shifts from in-person teaching and assessment to online. For many medical educators and learners, this has been the first time that their teaching and learning has taken place online. Also, it is well known that university students expect to use technology as a part of their studies, involvement of electronic teaching material to improve their achievement. The objective of this project was to estimate the health professional education staff and students' perception, evaluate their experience, recognize their barrier challenges of e-learning during COVID-19 pandemic, and investigate factors influencing the acceptance and use of e-learning as a tool of teaching within higher education, and the training of both staff and students to use these tools. The need for this project is supported firstly by a strategic plan to detect which e-learning tools we need and how could we start the training development program. Secondly, conduction of training need assessment survey were performed to both students and staff, followed by analysis of the survey, and according to the results, main line of training program were designed. The study design is interventional study, which was performed for both students and staff enrolled in integrated medical program at Faculty of Medicine for Girls Al-Azhar University, who was supposed to deal with different e-learning tools through comparing pre- and post-test training results and questionnaire to assess their satisfaction. About the result of this project, pre- and post-test were performed to all staff members and students every training session to assess the level of knowledge gain. Moreover, assignments were implemented to detect the strengths and weak points with all trainees to improve the results of the training program. The total number of students were 306, and the total number of the staff members were 285. Online survey were used, including a satisfaction question using a Likert scale in addition to open-ended question. Results revealed that the students were satisfied with using different e-learning tools and strongly recommended to increase use of it in many courses. Also, they are satisfied with learning materials and see that it was well organized. Students like to online tools as it is convenient, relaxing, and easy to access. Also encourage them to acquire the knowledge. Staff satisfaction were improved after faculty development program and were satisfied with using different e-learning tools as it allowed them to interact with the students and present the knowledge in simple ways. Students' performance and staff experience increased before and after program over time. It is concluded that overall satisfaction, performance, and experience were high. Advancing the use of the technology is an alternative and expedited approach for undergraduate and graduate health care providers. Thus, the use of various e-learning tools in active teaching can represent an ideal solution to maintain learning process with technical and infrastructure challenge. It is also represent a great solution to take advantage of the time and activities of the educational process. The Gantt chart of this project was composed of four phases, started with the phase one, complete approval and complete proposal, phase two, data collection, and phase three, also data collection, and finally, reporting and presentation. This part of the project was presented at the third virtual conference on nursing education and healthcare on 25th of September 2021. Thank you.